The U.S. Senate passes a bill to fund the government through mid-February, averting the risk of a shutdown. The Democratic-controlled chamber voted 69 to 28, sending the spending bill for President Biden's signature. Republicans had attempted to delay the vote in protest of vaccine mandates. Funding was set to run out on Friday, midnight, but Congress is facing another urgent deadline. The federal government is approaching its $28.9 trillion borrowing limit. The Treasury Department projects the government would reach this limit by December 15. Failure to extend or lift the limit in time could trigger an economically catastrophic default. U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen says the Omicron variant is proof the pandemic would persist for quite some time. But she hopes the continuing health crisis would not completely stifle economic activity, adding that the U.S. stimulus at the heart of the pandemic helped fuel a very strong recovery. Yellen also said lowering Trump-era tariffs on imported goods from China through a revived exclusion process could help ease some inflationary pressures.
I think the pandemic has contributed in very important ways to the inflation problem that we're facing. And the Trump tariffs that were put in place, some of them create problems without having any real strategic justification. Our U.S. Trade Representative, Catherine Tai, has been working with the Chinese, reviewing the phase 1 trade agreement. And she's opened up a process in which firms can apply. It's called our domestic tariff exclusion process in cases where the cost to Americans exceed any benefits of the tariffs. This is a process by which tariffs can be lowered. And I think that that could be helpful. Again, it's not a game changer, but these are things we're doing to try to mitigate these pressures.
Here at home, Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno appeals for calm as the Omicron variant continues to rattle financial markets, saying the reaction could be exaggerated. Let's hear more from Warren de Guzman.
Philippine shares were on a steep losing streak prior to Thursday's bounce. It was largely blamed on the new COVID-19 variant Omicron. Not much is known about Omicron yet, but the memory of how the Delta variant forced countries around the world back into hard lockdowns is still quite fresh. Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno, however, says he is not worried about it.
We'll continue our accommodative monetary policy until needed by the national government. We're not so concerned with the new virus, or with the new variant, rather. I think there's too much exaggeration on the impact of that. I think the best thing to do really for the Philippines is vaccinate, vaccinate, vaccinate.
Meanwhile, Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Carl Chua spoke at a forum of the Asian Institute of Management advocating the treatment of COVID-19 as endemic, which assumes the virus will not go away and mobility restrictions should not be used to address it. In other words, he too is calling for more vaccinations to fight the pandemic. Whether or not that means there will be no more hard lockdowns in the Philippines remains to be seen. Some business groups lobbied hard against tighter quarantine restrictions when the Delta variant was sending cases to new highs in August and September, but government still locked down the national capital region. And while vaccination levels have certainly improved, the Philippines still ranked last in the Bloomberg COVID resilience ranking for a third month in a row in November. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.
Mobile wallet GCash says it's ramping up efforts to protect consumers from smishing scams. GCash, along with Union Bank, were found to be among the payment portals used by scammers when asking money from their victims. It says it added extra security features designed to help customers detect and prevent fraud. GCash adds it's working closely with the National Privacy Commission and other government agencies to track and deal with any fraudulent cyber activities. The NPC is investigating telcos and payment platforms following the recent spate of spam messages here in the country.